Ya Satoshi, Inayu Usatoshewa, Kalyanana Satosoku, Palusa. Mianya Sualwaku Hanayahi. Nuyano Akulanayaha. Nianiwako Nayahilahi. Niasoto Shimiawa Alakunia Mania Soto Se. Pahure Se, Saniana Alakurio Sotosho, Kalo Rasha, Sati, Kaliana Noa Satashela. Good love, good light, illuminators and way showers. Thank you once again for being with me, Wendy, as we share once again the infinite, timeless, and multidimensional languages of lights, where absolutely everything in creation speaks a language of light, the harmony of the symphony of source. Nialukia Satasha. So excuse my appearance today, guys. I was just cleaning and cooking and interacting with several wonderful people today, and so I wanted to share this special new moon reading today with everybody, this multidimensional oracle message that comes from our emissaries of the Light Collective, those who have offered to lend their energy and love and guidance and experience and information through these light languages, through these channeled messages. And as I was writing in my journal today, the first thing I noticed was 4/16/2018 as I was writing the date, and I see in my mind's eye 4 and then 16 equaling 7 and then 2018 equaling 11. So I'm feeling this 4/7/11 energy, and then 4 and 7 equal 11, and then we've got the 11. So here we are having this like 11/11 gateway energy again, yet today's date equals 13, the number of transformation and together that adds up to the number 4. So we've got once again 4 and the 11/11 vibration. And as I was meditating to do this video, it turned 4/4/4 on the clock. So, as many of us know now, that the angels, the symbol, the number 4 and 4/4/4 does symbolize that of the angels, and even added together, it's 12, which equals 3, which is the triangle of the divine Merkabah, the body, mind, and spirit, and the divine Christ consciousness, the idea of the 333 energy, the 33rd parallel, and all of this was lending itself to the inspiration. So today's cup of inspiration today in my big polka dot W cup is going beyond the fifth dimension, about us understanding how we're going beyond the fifth dimension and how sound and light and light languages bring us into a vibration where we are literally vibrating, resonating closer to our source core vibration, that of pure light, pure love, this place where we remember our angelic nature, where we can hear the angels speaking. And so whatever it is that we do in the day, whether it's physical or meditating, every single thing we do is beyond this dimension. Everything we think goes beyond the fifth dimension, is multi-dimensional. In order for us to take a thought and create a thing, it has to become multi-dimensional. multi-frequential. And today was about the transformation of your life by rewriting relationships. I'm getting the tone in my ear again. Literally moving beyond this dimension and creating a reality, literally taking our dreams and placing them into the ethers and understanding the power we have. We really understand the power we have to manifest, that our thoughts literally become things, that sound vibrates through us and raises our vibration, that color and smells and scents raise our vibration. And I was just looking at some of the notes in my journal that I wrote earlier today about literally creating our reality and our relationships by visualizing the version of that relationship in which you want to see, with whomever that may be, especially yourself. What is the relationship to you? What is the relationship you want with yourself? What is the relationship you want with your guides? What is it? What is the relationship that you desire as your spiritual connection, your connection to source? What, and then when we bring it into the 3D, what relationships, what version of the relationships with other people do you want to experience? If it's not something you're experiencing it now, it's simply a matter of resonance and vibration. For we all, as law of attraction is the law, the universal laws of frequency and resonance and vibration, as every single thing is. We know electricity is vibration. We know that our hearts are vibration. We know that song and color is vibration. We know that, as my friend Yumi in Japan was, she's been singing light languages with plants and hooking them up to the EEG machine. Yeah, to everything is electrical current. Every single thing is a vibration. A radio station, a channel. That's why we're called channeling and channelers, because you're dialing into a particular frequential channel, which allows you access to whatever frequency others also are resonating in that channel are sharing, just like a radio station. They all exist. It's just which one you're tuning into. And so all of this information was coming through today in my meditations, and I was guided to my journal that I had drawn this a short time ago, and I was looking to see if I actually dated it. Going beyond the fifth dimension. The idea of the feather and the white magic, 5D, this all in one, 5D, going beyond the fifth dimension, planting the seeds for a new earth, and how our literally our thoughts become things, how we are power, everything resonates out into the beyond the dimensional world. And as each day followed, I was drawing more and more spirals, and these ideas of beyond these dimensions, of reaching, connecting beyond these dimensions, of peace, and this idea of creating manifestations in a new intentional collective of for the good of one, for the good of the all. What is going to be for the good of all of us, and seeing the ripple effects, that spiral effect. And think about Reiki, and I just completed the Galactic Reiki class. All cultures seem to use, and all healing modalities seem to use a spiral in some form. And Galactic Reiki is also about spirals and non-spirals. So we've got both going on. And the idea of sacred geometry and numerology and how it all ties, and how frequency and numbers and electricity and power and energy are all synchromatic, if that's even a word. And it's interesting how today being 13, the Syrian sacred circuit that was brought to us by Bashar through Daryl Anka, is 13 is transform. So here and here you have a circle, and then it implies a spiral. It implies transformation. It implies movement. It implies connectedness. It implies when you, especially if you can look at this image in your mind's eye as moving around as a more than two and three dimensional being, if you will. And seeing how it literally can manipulate energy, move energy. And isn't that what magic really is? It's just manipulating energy. It's manifestation through thoughts and intention. And this is what I think white magic is that of this ultimate transformation of how we use the power that we have from what we are, that we have been co-created with Gaia, and these gifts from Gaia and these co-creations, and the idea of the alchemy of flight of air and water and fire, and how the fan, you know, the feather fans the flame, and yet a bird can walk on, can fly in the air and swim in the water, and the phoenix, the bird of symbolization that symbolizes transformation, is coming out of the fire. Complete and utter transformation. And that's exactly what I was feeling all day. And some people shared with me today also that they had been drawing spirals. And so I just wanted to share a couple of the images that I had been drawing. I had the feather and the idea of the sacred vine and excuse me, and just these idea of the movement of energy, of moving through the multiple dimensions and stirring up the fire within us, and the idea of the 333 and the 444 and this and I'm even hearing 369 again, and how each of these is a derivative of three, and how Tesla, the idea of the 369 and free energy, and how all of this is interconnected, and how even the idea of bringing back our idea of what. There's Ranger again. Our idea of what magic really is, about what manifestation really is, about our power and how we can do it, and how we can do it for the greater good, and how when we do what's best for our highest spirit, it in turn creates the ripple effect, the resonance, as music would resonate out, as a singing bowl resonates out, it has its ripple effects. And I see the feather going through the air, how it actually can manipulate energy, and how birds can almost defy gravity because of their wings, and how we've always depicted angels as having wings. And so all of these ideas of spirals and swans and feathers and movement and water have been very significant in my awareness. And I had to laugh as I've been drawing all of these spirals and the idea of the sun and the inner sun. I've been drawing this for so long that I had forgotten how prevalent it had been for me. And I was all day long, I had just continually been drawing these suns and spirals, and it's something that I've been guided to as my own like signature logo, if you will, this idea of the sun and the spiral and light languages and the ripple effect that the languages of lights have on every single thing, on absolutely everything. And so today was about this idea of complete transformation. And I'm even hearing Will, the fountain of life. And truly moving beyond the dimensions as we understand them, and embracing this idea of transformation, and which led me then to synchronicity for myself. I had to laugh because I was wearing my apron today for cleaning and cooking. And I realized now I had made these years ago. And look what I drew. Suns, spirals. I bought three of these, and I made one for my sister and one for my mom. And I just drew with a permanent marker on each of them, different sun designs and things for each of them. And flowers and things, and it was like a connection for us that it and here it is, three of us. So there's this connection I was feeling today. And so I'm wearing this, I'm thinking about my mom, and I'm thinking about my sister, and I'm talking to one of my soul sisters today, chatting today, and we get a message from a mutual sister of ours, star sister, who happens to be named Star. And we met at the Pyramid Conference, the first Global Pyramid Conference, and she was one of the first people, strangers, and I'll share the story because it seems significant today for a few reasons. As I was sitting in the audience watching, I was listening, observing one of the speakers, I was guided to start writing galactic light language symbols in my pad, my notepad. And I was, all of a sudden, I heard, like, so it was like I heard a voice, a whisper say to me, "This is for the woman behind you." And I had spotted her in a couple of the different events, and I think we kind of nodded and smiled in acknowledgement in passing, but hadn't met her anything yet. And so it was the strongest, one of the most magnetic pulls I've ever had in my life. And I believe I might have even shared this in other videos, now that I think about it. But so I'm writing this, and I hear, "Hand it to the girl behind you, in the row behind you." And I turn around, and it's this girl. It's Star. Now, she looked at it, and I handed it to her, and she was just in awe of what she saw. And we immediately had this exchange, and then we spoke after the speaker was finished speaking. And sorry about that, guys. And so I'm up here in mints. Actually, many of these are from the conference. there was this almost electric. It was an energetic electric connection that happened between us that was inexplicable. And she was I don't think we knew it at the time, but then the next morning, I don't know if I said anything about light languages or not at that time. I don't remember now. Then the next morning, we met at breakfast, and she and I connected immediately, and she started speaking languages, and I started speaking languages, and there we were, you know, hush, 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 speaking languages, just weeping together with this connection. And I saw her brother. I saw a brother that she had, that she was connected to, that she hadn't been connecting to, and she said, "Oh my God, I can't believe that. I'm a twin and my brother died." And there was just so many, the hairs are standing on end, because the energy of that moment was so strong. And to speak galactic light languages with a person for the first time like that, that I didn't know, like I knew Brie already because she and I had gone together, and she spoke languages as well at the time. I think so, yeah. But it was the first time I ever had an interaction like that in a public place with somebody from, and she lives in Canada, so she doesn't even live in the States. And so it was one of the most profound experiences of my life. And so today, I'm chatting with Bree, and that's the funny, well, synchronistic part of that too. I'm chatting with Bree, and she said, did you hear from Star? Her mother just transitioned. And then a little while later, just a few minutes later, actually, then Star sent me a message. And so I was thinking about my own mom and how great, how I was feeling this gratitude as I'm cooking and cleaning. And I was even thinking about my mom because I my dishwasher is broken right now, so we're waiting for a part. And I've been having to wash dishes by hand lately. And yet, as much as it's, you know, time consuming and it allows me to actually meditate. I go into a meditative state when I'm washing dishes or, and so it really allows me, or even if I, it allows me to transport myself to other places and dimensions and hear messages. And so I was thinking about, you know, just doing dishes and being a kid and when I didn't have a dishwasher, just things like that. And my mom and cooking just being grateful that she taught me these kind of basic cleaning and cooking skills and things like that. And thinking about my mom and sending her healing energy because she's having some health issues. And so any of you healers out there, my mom's could use a little love, some TLC. And so thank you all. So I've been sending my mom energy and Reiki energy. And so all of this seems so synchronistic. And so as I'm feeling this gratitude and I'm thinking about our friend Star, and I was wanting to do, so I was finishing up what I was doing and I was reminded of the angels. I was feeling this such angelic energy wrap around me, as if I was literally feeling an angel wrapping its like wings around me. And it feels so warm and wonderful, as it's like a swirling feeling. And I guess when I'm thinking about spirals, that's sometimes how it feels when our chakras are moving and we're feeling this beautiful energy within us. When I connect, my experience is often this swirling of beauty and love and bliss. And sometimes it's colors, sometimes it's white, pure light. Sometimes there's this void of just nothing, bliss. But it's always feeling us like a stirring, this energy within me, like the sun within me that just that glows and glows. And I feel it in my heart chakra and my throat chakra. And sometimes it can bring me to tears. And then I can feel even now, like my, my head's too kind of tingly. I was guided to, ask the angels, you know, the archangels, you know, who is it that can help me and us today to send this energy out to all of us, any of you who are grieving, who have lost, when we say lost, who have experienced a three-dimensional focused energy in our awareness that has moved beyond the fifth dimension, moved beyond the third dimension. And to let us know, to remind us that it's simply a transformation, and that it's not an ending, it's a new beginning. And on this new moon, I thought it was so fitting that this idea of complete transformation and number 13, and I'm getting tones in my ears on both, you know, on and off on both, that it's a spiral. It's always a cycle, a circular energy that we never stop. We never stop. We go like a spiral out and out and out, and we touch and we intermingle, but we never stop. We never cease. And whether it's a pet that we've lost, there's been people, my friend Jody, hey Jody, hey, honey, you know, and I've lost pets in my life and family members. And so even now I'm being reminded of my niece who made her transition just a few short years ago, right before her 16th birthday, and how I have to remember, even though it was suicide, I have to remember she's here. She's transitioned. She had an experience, and the ripple effects that experience and all those that created and co-created that experience with her, and all those that co-create these experiences with all of us, and how the web effect, and how I even grabbed my spider stone today, and the creamy in here, which we'll get to in a minute, this creamy white color. But the spider is the symbol of creativity. So think about the spider web and how it goes out into that spiral. And so I was reminded today of Archangel Azrael. Archangel Azrael is, and I want to make sure, is the one whose specialty is healing grief. And that God helps us heal grief. And the aura color is this creamy white. And so I was also, I was reminded my Archangel bookmark here. So is this creamy white color. And so I was guided to, the crystal is creamy yellow calcite. So I had my healing bag here, my healer's bag here with my golden dragon. And this was a gift. And we have this creamy yellow calcite. So we've got this solar plexus energy swirling around, and this idea of transforming, that we can transform our belief systems collectively about what death means, about what this transition means. It's very interesting that Brie and I were also discussing this last night about changing. Very interesting how it was almost like this was preconceived, not conceived, pre-notioned, if you will. And there's a huge hawk flying by right now. As if I knew, because everything's now, I knew that this was going to happen today in some way, shape, or form, because we were just discussing this last night about changing the collective consciousness about what death actually means and transition actually means. And so there was so many of these beautiful synchronicities today that I wanted to show how we're, once again, a symbol of harmony, a symbol of how we're creating our own magic. And I wanted to show you guys these little tiny glasses because my mom gave these to me. I've always been one of these people, ever since I was a kid, and talk about our inner child. So I've always liked things that represent that things were not the size that they normally are. So like a teeny tiny pair of glasses, or like for one time she bought me this bag, like a zipper bag, carry bag, but it was a big giant tennis shoe. So I like this idea of representation of the paradox. And so today was about seeing things from a different point of view. And this is why I keep this little pair of glasses here, because it just is a permission slip for me that says, let's see, help me every day see things from a new perspective, a perspective from God's perspective, from this perspective of a purer light. And so for all of you who are experiencing those who, as I've been receiving from my guides, who have decided to make their transition prior to this big shift, prior to whatever this big shift is, there are many who have decided, who have agreed, if you will, to come, but to make that transition before this transition. And this is for all of us who are here, who are here to usher in this new earth beyond the fifth dimension, beyond the third dimension, the fourth dimension, the fifth dimension, to create this fifth dimensional earth. Those that have come to bring us here, but that have decided to make their transition beforehand and leaving the torch in our hands, leaving the feather in our hands, that we create the new magic on the earth, because they brought us here. And now it's our time. It's your turn. It's our turn and time to make the difference here, and to remind us all that all of us are going through a perfect cycle, a perfect transition, and that whatever time any of us created as exit points throughout our creation, I was even reminded we were talking about that yesterday too, about near-death experiences, and how I had a near-death experience, which I'll share with all of you at some point if I haven't already. And I was actually washing dishes. That is so weird too, because I was thinking about that. I was talking about it with her last night, and then today I was talking with her about the near-death experience last night, and then today was I was washing dishes and all of this, and I started, it's like, okay, interesting how everything is now and how time is malleable and melding, and how my near-death experience had to do with water and energy and electricity. So, you know, how all of these are triggers for everything, how everything is really now, and you're just experiencing it from a different spot on the web. And so for all of us who need soothing to understand, there's so many large hawks flying around right now. It's incredible. They're all over the place. So feel Azrael's warm, creamy white wings holding you, wrapping their arms around you, reminding you that you still have access to all of these people, all of these animals, all of these energies. You must simply just allow and stop believing you can't. Soothe the part of your soul that forgets that this transition is a complete and utter pure cycle of transformation and the spiral of life, of which you never ever end. Mia sato somielo hama kolia senote senisha sana la koma la kira sona se la candiara sono shero na 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 ko pira sono le shemale ondare sena ilane awa kore antashanara ke Sopokoya anaya salusa. Mokora seto sona ya shaloma lakaya. Lokira sononiamu onama ananana kuela kote. Sonondo ya shanote wakosa. And remember those that you interact with, that you are born from, with, connected to in any way. The essence of all of you is intermingled with all of you, just as the essence of Source, Light, God is intermingled in all things. it is exactly the same. Therefore, there is never any separation in the connection. It is just the acting, the spiraling of the belief systems. I'm going to take a quick drink here. Thanks, guys. And thank you, the archangels, for allowing your highest joys to help us move through these understandings of multidimensionality, of our connections to all things, to God, to Source, to mostly ourselves and who we are, this needing to know and wanting to know all that we are, all that we come from, and yet there is no place and nowhere you do not come from. You may access these experiences anytime you desire. This is what you see in these past lives. This is what you see in these ideas of regressions, the idea of reincarnation, of each of us having a new beginning, an endless, infinite. We lose the idea, we lose the understanding even of what infinite actually is. We cannot conceive the infinite. But that means never, ever ending. You cannot conceive that you are actually existing in an infinite, billions and billions and billions and billions of realities simultaneously right now. Right now. We can't even imagine. The number of messages and images and sensations and light codes and information and data that we are receiving in every single fraction of a breath. So I was guided today. Yes, Sotasha, and this idea of transformation. So me also no quiero to ask our guides by way of these oracle messages. Oh, one bubble just fell out. Well, there you guys go. This is the Earth magic deck. Shaman. I just want to look closer at this. Such a strong, powerful, ancient healing wisdom. Look at the white hair, the feathers, the creamy white on the face, the creamy white colors, the whole thing, all of this, all creamy white. You guys are shaman. We are shaman. This is what they do. This is what we do. We connect to beyond the fifth dimension and bring this energy to the human collective, to not just the entire conscious collective. There's a sharing of energy. They reach in and grab this energy. What an absolutely perfect card. The color, the strength, the softness, the knowing, the confidence. And it is the shaman, the shamanic journey, the drums, the music, the resonance, the power of vibration and sound and tones and singing and languages. Creating what we feel is magic upon this earth. Being able to literally dance with the elements, work with the elements. Mashuari Samiaro say. In a divine alchemical dance, and bringing this energy to us all for the betterment for the betterment of an entire species. And this is the Sacred Traveler deck from Denise Lynn. The back of the Earth Magic, once again, the tree of life, the sun coming up from the grounds, the meadow, the jewels and the trees reaching. We are all shaman. We are all have access to every branch of every tree, of every root. See yourselves as you ground yourselves and root the energy and gather this energy from Gaia. Gather this energy from the spirit world as you root and ground. Just as the shaman, noha mu asato shebedana. What information do we need from our shaman today as we travel on this sacred journey? Soshe, oh my God, protected by angels. You guys, you hear me shuffling. Oh my God, you are cherished by the angels. The strength, the softness, and look at the color, the creamy, pure, creamy white, yellow. Oh my God, you guys, look, you just can't make it up, right? Wow. Let us take now this moment of gratitude to our angels and Yahweh. Once again, thank you for devoting yourselves to all that is in the service and the idea of service to all that is, just as we here in this now, in this glowing, beautiful energy, we dedicate our love, our light, our work to the good of our souls, which reaches the spirals to the good of the all. Thank you, our archangels, for being with us and helping us understand all that we are and our connection to you and the one divine mother and the one divine father. Thank you. And this is the Psychic Tarot Oracle by John Holland. And I like the picture on the front of this too. Here we are going beyond this fifth dimension. There we are. Look, and the creamy energy, blue chakra energy, gold. Masoto Shemiara Sonoria, the stars. Yasoto Sami Awo Anukwa Soposhonori Ubusa Dari Kishnara said. Boy, you guys. Wisdom. There we are, standing, holding the key to divine wisdom, the book of divine wisdom, the number 5, which represents the direction, it represents humanity and transforming and moving in a new direction. And the dog, I love this. It's the year of the dog, you guys. So look, it's the Chinese year of the dog. And I was just sending my love to my buddy Ranger, and we were just talking about pets. And all of us that have been so blessed by the unconditional love of the time we have received with our own loving pets. The wisdom that we receive from the angels. And there, walking to the house, the divine wisdom, bringing the divine wisdom. As you receive this inner wisdom and you share this inner wisdom, you share with humanity. Look at this yellow light within you. Here we go. The sun, you guys, the spiral. There it is. Allow your wisdom. Allow yourselves to gain the wisdom and to receive the wisdom and the light within you to share that wisdom with another. This is what teachers do. You are the teachers of the teachers. You are the illuminators. You are the way showers. We are here to show the way. This light, look. We're here to show the way. The torch has been given to us to say, create the earth in a new way. You are all the new teachers, the new manufacturers, the new designers, the new creators, the new internet platform creators, you guys are doing it. You guys are the ones out there creating the new earth, created in this new idea of 4711, walking through the gateway of higher wisdom and knowledge and sharing that for the good of the all. Mistoto shoma ala seteshe. No kuresemi salusono balihana teke. Lusona. And I love the back of these gateway oracle cards. And masoto she somoteda shambag Denise Lynn as well. Ipokoshanateki. So now I was just looking at that shaman card again too, and the protected by angels. I'm blown away by this. I mean, I don't know, but my solar plexus chakra is just like, oh, spinning. Sodishimiya. And I know I just passed 444. Didn't 4444, you guys. Sorry. So pariya satoshimiya aloha mani wisa sapalohina na yaki. Oh, so no, it's, yeah. Excuse me. So to some mechanical, yeah, I get so excited. So nikinyara satopalahaniki. And these cards just have everything. They have the water, the air, the fire, the earth, the tree of life, the vine of life, the purity of water, knowing that we have access to the earth, the air, the water, the fire, the ethers, the light of all that is, the gifts of Gaia that we are here to take and receive, to receive and give the gifts of Gaia from and to her, to each other, to create this vision of the planet that we want to see, the education system we want to see, the medical health system the way we want to see, the familial system that we want to see, the equality and actual equality for all living beings. Niatoro shimiato sama awa ma iatasha dakila hanakalia sotake. So no di bikia soto sumaya. Listen, notice about it. There's so many planetary aspects right now. Miatosha ye. Inotori sama iwakwana that I'll get into in another video. Imashoto sama iwamasha, because they're very strong right now and very significant as to what is happening right now and how it relates to me, my own childhood, how I came to be on this journey, how it all affects all of us. Now so no my alosoto pashinara sokola hala. Lenina Naniano. Believing in magic. All right. Sometimes I just true magic is abounding in my life, and I see a spiral, a key, music symbols, stars, a new moon, the dolphin, the white bird, the symbol of white magic, flowers, the ankh, the key of life, sailing, hearts, the star of David, the Merkaba, the Metatron energy, the triple spirals, the oh my God, there's even a lightning bolt, and it looks like a radio, like transmissions. So we got it all today, guys. Believe in magic. You are here to bring the white magic back to the earth. The pure, pure, the pure golden white angelic light magic of manifestation back to the earth. Your inner shaman, you are a shaman. We are the shaman. We are here to create the new earth, to go on, to go beyond the fifth dimension. And we are protected by angels. There we are, the golden energy, the golden sword, of peace, harmony, strength, courage, the creamy, once again, white energy. We, knowing that you are protected by angels, the shaman are angels. Earth angels, share your wisdom. 1111 energy. Believe. The true magic is flowing through my life. Miharo sono biara sonora, kamayo sonose. Mi nani anonkua porososhe sanatala. Pohasha sanate. Sono toshimakia sanasesa. Mianone amaniki. La seda 13. Niaposhana. Complete transformation. Napose teshinata. The white feather. Somute shamara, sonika alatera, sonotara shamasa, somoria satoriamba, inania, nori sopora sonari, somikia sonotikila, diana, duoshi mianukua, pali sanato, kaima sato, masharsona, tariingara, tainga, soniki la sonosha, payasa, La tamina lo elokosa somina ni naniato o ama o alinki o anasho lo sona shatokua mia sanonde. It has been an honor and a privilege to serve you today in this now, in this way. Niato somikua sonote pa awu anokua. And the emissaries of the light collective, those whose highest joy also is that of service to all that is in any way that they may be of service to us in this now, in this way. Yahu nakwala, so siamo awa shanato ewa o hanaka, and that all perspectives are unique perspectives, and all perspectives are that of the one source. All are each and every one perfect and unique, as you are perfect and unique. Each of you carrying a very unique alchemization of information, of wisdom, that you are being now divinely asked as a guide, a teacher, a way shower, an illuminator, to carry this wisdom out into the world, to believe that you are walking magic. No ona kialosa tachi miatoshi, and we are one. No kosia miasha. I love you, miakoya nata, and I thank you for being with me, Wendy, as we engage and embrace, expand our multidimensional awareness to know and love ourselves beyond ways we have ever been able to before. Niakosha, I love you. And if there is any way that I can be of a service to you on your journey, please. Niakosha na. I am honored. Niatoya. In grace and gratitude and love, we are one. I love you. Mahala. Namaste. Niakosha.